la casa?
Yo aquí me quedo.
¿Y hay gente adentro ya?
¿Ah?
¿Y hay gente adentro?
Sí, ya están todos los que van allí.
Vamos a entrevistar.
¡Padre Brian!
Sí, buenos días.
Adelante. Tomen asiento un poquito.
¿Para la casa? Favor. Vámonos para la casa ya.
No, hombre,
¿cómo estás? ¿Cómo estás? ¿Ya te vas para la casa? ¿Sí? ¿De qué parte vienes?
De Chiapas.
¿En Chiapas? ¿Ya te vas a rezar a Tapachula? ¿O qué parte?
Tonalá.
¿Tú eres de Tonalá, de Jalisco? ¿Vas para atrás? De Chiapas. Ah, ¿Tonalá, Chiapas?
Sí, antes de Tapachula.
Oh, ok. ¿Y te vas a regresar?
Sí.
Ay, ay, ay. Bueno. Señora, ¿usted de dónde es?
De también, de Tonalá, Chiapas.
¿De Tonalá, Chiapas?
Es su
hija.
Sí.
Ah, mira, nada más. De aquí está para cualquier cosa que ocupen. ¿Ok? Ándale, señora. Ahorita les hago una entrevistita. How's everybody doing? How's everybody doing? Good morning. This is the bus, people, that is going to take people back home. We're inside the bus, Border Network News. I'm bringing you the reality and the truth about the caravan. Hi, good morning. I'm Oscar Blue for Border Network News. We're live as we are inside the bus of the return back home bus. This bus is... they're using this bus right now as people that they want to return back home and they don't want to stay in the shelters anymore. And this is not full. You know, we're about to see a little bit more people. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 people that they are returning back home. Let us see if we can talk to somebody right here. Buenos días. ¿Vas para la casa ya?
Ya, vamos para la casa.
Sí, ¿de dónde eres?
De Honduras.
¿De Honduras? I'm asking him where he's from. He's saying from Honduras. I'm telling him, are you going back home? And he's saying yes. ¿Cuánto tiempo estuviste aquí?
2 semanas.
2 semanas. How much time you been here? He's saying 2 weeks. ¿Te viniste con tu hija?
Sí.
You came with your daughter. ¿Ya no quisiste más?
No, ya no.
Ya no. ¿Y por qué es la razón que ya no quisiste más?
Porque... no tengo quien cuide a la niña para trabajar y aquí no dan un permiso de trabajo. Y pues la razón es que está un poco complicado dejar a los hijos con otra persona que uno no conoce. Y la verdad que no hay como regresar a su casa.
They're saying that practically, you know, he doesn't have nobody that can take care of her daughter. They don't have a work permit to work over here. And, you know, he's suffering too much, so he's returning back home. Les están mintiendo de la facilidad de cruzar a los Estados Unidos. Les dicen que es fácil.
Sí.
Y llegan acá y no es cierto. Es toda una mentira. ¿Qué es lo que le mandas decir a toda la gente que está allá en Centroamérica?
No, cada quien tiene sus razones por venir a intentar y cada quien sabe lo bueno y lo malo. Y pues si ellos deciden venir a intentarlo, ellos saben las razones por qué salen del país de
Canadá. I'm telling them that, you know, they're lying to them. They're saying that, that it's easy to cross the United States, but when they get over here, it's still difficult, and he's saying that, you know, everybody has their own reasons to come over here, and everybody has their own methods. Pues mucha suerte en tu viaje. Te deseo lo mejor. Bye. I'm saying good luck in your trip, and ¿va para casa, jefe?
Sí.
Sí. ¿De dónde es usted?
De Guatemala.
¿De Guatemala? Sí. Va a cruzar por allá por Suchiate, ¿no? Sí. Se va a cruzar para atrás. Sí, acabo de ir para allá, jefe. Acabo de ir para allá, pero creo que no me quiere. Está bien, no lo quiero incomodar. Señora, ¿cómo está? Mucho gusto, Oscar el Blue. ¿De dónde es, señora?
De Guatemala.
De Guatemala. Va para allá, para Guatemala ya.
¿Sí?
Guatemala es precioso, señora.
Ajá.
La moneda del quetzal vale más que el peso. El único problema ya es que creo que no hay trabajo, ¿no?
Ajá, sí,
sí. ¿Y esa es su razón por venir para acá?
Ajá.
¿Y ahora qué es lo que van a hacer ahora? ¿Ya intentó? ¿Cuánto tiempo estuvo aquí?
A ver qué hacemos allá para ver.
¿Mande?
A ver qué hacemos para salir adelante, ¿no?
¿Pero cuánto tiempo estuvo aquí?
Sí. ¿Aquí en el albergue?
Sí.
3 días ahora, creo.
3 días. ¿Y aquí en, aquí en México?
Por todo casi como 25 días.
25 días. Ya no más.
Sí,
dijo, no. Ya no. Mejor vámonos para
sí,
atrás.
Ajá.
Es una falacia lo que están diciendo de Estados Unidos, ¿verdad?
Ajá.
Que es fácil cruzar.
No es fácil
cruzar.
No es fácil.
Ok, muchas gracias y que tenga suerte en su viaje, señora. ¿Cuánto están pagando por el viaje? Mil pesos, ¿no? ¿Mil pesos? Sí. I'm asking her what like. Thank you so much. Que tengan buen viaje todos.
Gracias.
Y que les vaya muy bien, ¿ok?
Gracias.
I'm telling them basically where she's from. She's saying from Guatemala. And basically what she's saying is that she's been here 25 days. It's a lie what they're telling them, that it's easy to go and cross to the United States. It's a lie. They're realizing that. That is a good thing, people, that they're realizing that it is a lie, that it's real difficult to cross to the United States, and that also ultimately it's difficult to get a work permit for the gentlemen or for the women, that they have children and they have to leave it over here in the Agape shelter or whatever shelter they're stationed at, and it's real difficult to be coming over here. You know, this migrant right here from Guatemala told her, you know what, the quetzal is more valuable than the peso. She's saying yes, but the problem over there is the work. So they're going back to Guatemala. They don't want to stay in Mexico. This is the bus, people, for everybody to know. Border Network News bringing you the reality, the news of a bus, the return back home bus right here. It's going to be a long ride, this bus. The cushion, it doesn't look that comfortable. It's going to be a long ride. Señora, ahora sí. ¿Cuánto tiempo estuvo aquí?
2 meses y medio.
2 meses y medio. Sí. How much time you been here? 2 months and a half. Es muy difícil cruzar los Estados Unidos. O sea, es básicamente casi imposible, ¿no?
No, nosotros venimos porque tenemos familiares acá.
Ustedes vinieron porque tienen familiares,
sí,
aquí.
Tengo mis hijos y mi nuera, mi nieta.
We came over here because we got family members over here in Tijuana. ¿Y ahora por qué se regresan?
Porque yo nada más vine a cuidar a mi nuera por su parto.
Ah, okay. Yes, I just came here to take care of one of my family members, for she was going to give birth. Entonces ya se van para casa ya.
Sí, ya vamos de regreso, sí, porque sí, mi hija entra a la escuela.
Oh, yeah. Va de regreso a la escuela.
Sí.
Ah, okay.
Por eso regresamos.
Ah, muy bien, muy bien. Tapachula es precioso, señor. Acabo de ir para allá yo.
Sí.
Me crucé hasta en las balsas por el Suchiate, fíjese nada más cómo andaba.
Pues nosotros también es primera vez que viajamos por acá para Tijuana y está muy bonito, los gustó.
Sí, les gustó, sí, mucho. Hay mucho trabajo aquí, señora.
Bastante.
Hay mucho trabajo.
Estuvo trabajando a mi hija y le gustó también.
Ah, no, pues hay mucho trabajo.
Y mis hijos acá trabajan, uno ya tiene 5 años que está y el otro tiene 4.
Ah, muy bien.
Y sí, les va de maravilla.
Ah, no, pues qué bueno. Sí. Pues aquí ya les dejé ahí un contacto y ya lo que ocupen, ¿ok?
Ah, ok.
Andale, pues.
Gracias.
Bye. Bye. Those are economic migrants. Hola, ¿cómo estás? Déjame. Sí. Te regreso a casa ya.
Ya.
Sí. ¿De dónde eres?
De Chiapas.
De Chiapas. You're coming. Where are you coming from? They say in Chiapas. ¿De qué parte de Chiapas?
Tapachula.
Tapachula. Ah, yo andaba allá, fíjate.
Sí, está muy bonito por allá.
No, sí, está muy, muy bonito por allá. ¿Cuál es tu opinión ahorita de lo que está sucediendo con los migrantes que están entrando fuertemente por Tapachula? What is your opinion about all the migrants that are entering Tapachula?
Estuvo muy pesado porque hay ciertas personas que no vienen en paz. La delincuencia aumentó muchísimo. El parque central estuvo muy feo.
Horrible.
Muy apestoso. Se hacían el baño ahí. Su ropa por donde quiera. Se bañaban en la fuente. Se supone que es parte fundamental del parque, que da la vista para el parque central.
Pues es una parte histórica, ¿no?
Uh-huh. Y pues no respetaban nuestras culturas ni nada, pues.
So she's saying basically she's from Chiapas, people. She came, ¿cuál es la razón por qué viniste para acá? ¿Querías migrar a los Estados Unidos?
No.
¿Qué?
Mi esposo es uno de los choferes del camión.
Oh, sí. She's saying that the driver of the bus is her husband. So this is the wife of the driver of the bus. This is really interesting that we have a little talk with her. So she's not a migrant, people. She's just coming with the driver of the bus, that the driver of the bus is from Tapachula, Chiapas. She's saying that she lives really happy over there in Tapachula. I'm asking her what happened with the migrants and what is her opinion of the migrant, of the caravan, as soon as they entered Tapachula, saying that it's been awful. Center Park has been disgustingly, destroyed. And, you know, it's been having a lot of bad time with violence and delinquency over there with the migrants. Que tengan muy bonito viaje.
Gracias.
Próximamente, Dios quiere, voy para allá otra vez. Okay. Nos vemos allá. Yo creo que voy a ir a Tapachula. Voy, yo creo, en unos, si no son 2 semanas, en menos de 2 semanas, o en esta semana a lo mejor me voy.
Okay,
nos vemos allá. Que tengan muy bonito viaje.
Gracias.
Ándale. Vámonos. ¿Nomás ustedes se van a ir?
Creo que sí.
¿Eh? Well, this is the bus, people. We were thinking that it was going to be a lot of people in the bus. The bus, you know, approximately has capacity. I will ask how much the capacity of the bus has. We have people from Guatemala and people from Honduras that they're going back. And the person that it was all the way to the front, it was the wife of the driver. And she was explaining to us that she says that the caravan has damaged Tapachula. Said Tapachula is beautiful, huh? I told her, yes, I've been over there. I've been there for 3 days. I was there for 3 days. I landed on a Tuesday at 12 o'clock at noon. Worked the whole Tuesday, worked the whole Wednesday. Came back on a Thursday. So I was there like 3 days. And Tapachula is beautiful, people. And it's been damaged by the caravan. And as you can see, experienced by by her own mouth, saying to everybody that, Tapachula has been damaged by the caravan and a vast amount of destruction and every part of Tapachula. This is media right here by Telemundo, right here doing interviews. And as we are awaiting more people, the bus is awaiting more people. As we are right here at the Agavet shelter, the construction on the top is pretty amazing, people. Let us go over there to show you how the church is from the United States that is called, I don't remember the name of the church. But it's, voy a voltear la cámara para que no te la ponga, por favor. Estoy volteando la cámara para que no los ponga. No se preocupe, no se preocupe. This is how they're building the second floor, people. It's going. Do you remember a time that me and Cindy were sitting right here in the middle? And there was none of this construction going on. And now they're building another floor in the Agape shelter. This shelter is huge. So, this is for you guys to know. Let's go down and see the kitchen. Let's go down and see the kitchen. There's people on my back over here that I don't want to show. They have kids. But just for everybody to know, I'm Oscar Blue for Border Network News. Let me change the camera here for a little bit. Where is it? Right there. How's everybody doing? Good morning. I'm Oscar Blue for Border Network News. We're live again at the Agape shelter as a bus, the go back home bus has landed over here in the Agape shelter. And we have seen only apparently like around 6 or 8 individuals that they want to go back home. Honduras and Guatemala. And the cost for to go back home is 1,000 pesos. That is around $50 to $60. And also the bus is not filled, people. I thought that it was going to be a little bit more people inside the bus, but there's only like 6 or 7 people. So, you know, it's a start. It's a start for this program. That is the going back home program. Again, the bus, the cost for the ticket, for the bus ticket is 1,000 pesos. That is around $50 to $60. And we're live over here. And as I was showing you how the Agape shelter is growing, it's growing a lot, as you guys see. So I will have more information for you guys. We are about to do the Mexican feed. We're about to do the Mexican feed for everybody to know. I'm Oscar Blue for Border Network News, people. Let me see if I can get an interview with the person in charge right here to get a minute of her time before I go, and then get an interview with the pastor. See if I can get a couple seconds. Right here. There she comes. Here she comes. I will do it in Spanish and English, people, for everybody to know. Let us get her. She is the person in charge over here. Buenas tardes. Oscar Blue para Border Network News. Muy bien. El día de hoy, el camión para regresar a casa, son pocos, pero ya es un comienzo, ¿no?
Son pocos, lo voy a decir porque no hay quien les retire el dinero porque les están mandando. Ellos no pueden porque tienen sus identificaciones aquí, no tienen validez, ¿no? Entonces, tenemos más de 100 personas que quieren retornar, no tienen el dinero, por eso no se han ido, pero aquí están en espera, por eso son poquitos.
Okay.
Ayer al 10 se fueron en 40 años.
Okay, she's saying that basically there's a few people right now inside the bus because they cannot retrieve their money. They cannot cash out their money because they don't have identification. But there's a little bit of more of 100 people that they want to return back home. Yesterday, there was a quantity of 40 people that they want to go back home. La mayoría se está yendo pues decepcionados, ¿no? Porque llegan y piensan que es fácil cruzar los Estados Unidos cuando la realidad de las cosas es otro cuento.
La mayoría fue engañada. Están aquí porque les dijeron, llévate a tu hijo, llevas a tu hijo, tienes el pase directo, tienes trabajo, ahí te van a estar esperando, llegas, firmas y te vas con la empresa que te contrata, ¿no? Eso estoy hablando de los que vienen por la pobreza, pero de las personas que traen un caso, que están amenazados de muerte y que tienen sustentado su caso, no tienen un abogado. No tienen el abogado porque no tienen el dinero para pagar. Supone que están huyendo, no traen dinero, ¿verdad? Los familiares pues no tienen el dinero suficiente para pagar un abogado. Entonces dicen ellos, automáticamente yo pierdo. Prefiero regresarme a mi país, sé que corro peligro, pero voy a estar cerca de mi familia. No voy al lugar donde está mi familia porque corro peligro, pero en algún momento voy a poder verlo, ¿no?
Okay.
Entonces están pidiéndole el apoyo a su familia para el pasaje nada más.
Muy bien.
Y hacen responsables a esas personas que de alguna manera les están negando, ¿no?
Uh-huh.
La posibilidad de vivir, dicen ellos.
De vivir. Sí. Pues muchísimas gracias, muy amable por ese minutito de su tiempo. La dejo trabajar, porque sé que tiene un día muy ocupado. That's basically she's saying, people, that there's more than 100 migrants that they want to go back home, but they don't have money. And also, she's saying that they have deposit money in some places like Western Union and all that stuff, but they need an ID over here. And they don't have a way to take out the money. Also, she said, she emphasized, there's more than 100 people that they want to return back home, but they don't have the money to just get there. The cost is 1,000 pesos for each person. So they don't have the money. Well, they have it, but they can't take it out. Yesterday, 40 of them returned back home. So today we see a few of them because it's not the reason that they don't want to go back home. It's because they can't take out the money out of what their family members are sending them. So basically she's saying, I ask her again, you know, they came here with a dream, with their illusion, and they're going back home now. And she's saying, yes, you know, they lie to them. Like, you know, they've been lying to them. They get home, a lot of them, they're economic migrants. And, you know, they get here and they think that it's going to be real easy, and they lie to them over here. And the other ones that they have, like death threats or, you know, a really difficult case of security or a really difficult case of, of, you know, of rescue for their lives. Those migrants, you know, they get here and they don't have a money for a lawyer. So that's the thing. That's the thing, that they don't have money. They get here and they know that the United States is not accepting political asylum. They get a 3% chance, and they're lying to them. A thing that we've been emphasizing since I started, you know, it's a lie. It's a lie that you can migrate to the United States. Every Tijuana citizen knows that it's extremely difficult to get the political asylum to cross to the United States. And, you know, and now they're realizing that, and there's this bus, people, for everybody to know. There's the bus of returning back home. I will change the camera right here before I go. How's everybody doing? I'm Oscar Blue for Border Network News. I'm live right here at the Agape Shelter where the return back home bus landed today, and it landed yesterday. Today, we've seen approximately around 6 to 8 people. And yesterday, 40 people returned back home. And apparently there was more than 100 people that wanted to go back home, but they don't have money. We saw the interview with the person in charge of the administrative, person in charge of the Agape shelter. And she told us that basically they're lying to them. That is what the reason why they want to return back home. They don't trust anything and anyone anymore. So stay tuned, people. I will go to another shelter to check out how the health department is taking care of the people from Africa. If they're really getting medically assist, if they're really checking them the proper way to see if they have a disease or to see if they have Ebola or to see if they are sick. Let's emphasize on that. That is extremely important for every Mexican citizen, every Tijuana citizen, and ultimately is it really important for the United States. People, I'm Oscar Blue for Border Network News. I will be live in the Mexican feed in a few seconds in the page of Tierra Libertad with Oscar Blue.